And then go to Infowars.com to the articles we have, and they're full of dozens of clips. This one right here, Washington Post, London Guardian, all of them making jokes about it. Well, let me read you the headline. Sound of Freedom is QAnon conspiracy theory for fathers with brainworms. I got a six-year-old daughter. I got two other daughters. And I'm telling you, man, you're crossing the line, CNN. And you're crossing the line, New York Times and Washington Post and all the rest of you damn people. It's Sunday, July 9th, 2023. And I'm your host, Alex Jones. Thank you so much for joining us. We've got a big broadcast lined up for you.
InfoWars, the most banned network in the world. The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Well, I tend to get a little bummed out here on air, a little pessimistic and upset, because a lot of innocent people are being fed into satanic meat grinders in a thousand different ways every day, conservatively. But in the main, evil is in a lot of trouble, and the Great Awakening is undoubtedly here now. So I'll be completely honest with you. I don't really pay attention to Hollywood, even the Christian Hollywood that's taking over and is successful while the old satanic Hollywood's dying. So I had not really paid any attention to the Sound of Freedom. I like Mel Gibson a lot. I mean, you talk about he's not some Johnny come lately to fight in the New World Order. He's been aware of it since he was a kid. I'm friends with his dad, Hutton, who's an expert on the New World Order before I was born. And I like Caviezel and all that, but I thought it was a fiction movie. I did a bunch of research this weekend when it hit number one, and I was like, wow, this is a true story? And so I kind of feel not dumb. I'm usually way ahead of the curve, except when you're so far ahead of the curve, you kind of already know all this stuff. You think, well, what's Hollywood, even if it's Christian Hollywood, going to show me? I mean, the UN has kidnapped hundreds of thousands of women and children we know of and put them in sex slavery. And it used to be all over the news. London Guardian, Associated Press, until about 10 years ago. And big tech got so good at control that you don't even see that stuff anymore. I mean, it's in my major films, just newscast clips admitting industrial level sex trade, sex slavery. The term for it's white slavery. Has nothing to do with white people. It's just the old term is white slavery, sex slavery. That's the technical name for it. And so I'm going to go see the movie tonight, but I've read a transcript of it. We got the director and other people coming on this week, the star of it, all of them. Big fans of those guys, Roger Stone. It's on the show tomorrow. He hung out with Trump and Mel Gibson. Roger Stone was also, I guess, hanging out with Joe Rogan. So that's a good thing. So those guys are all together. The radicalization of Joe Rogan is almost complete. You know, that's my main job is actually waking people up across the political spectrum, especially the big dogs. Been working on Rogan for 25 years. Some special project. One of my, I don't take all the credit for it, just, you know, large serving of the credit. I would take the majority of the credit for his radicalization. I know it's angered the system quite a bit. but seriously, the system radicalized Joe Rogan because the system is who is radical. So I was already going to start the show today and just talk about the giant awakening that is happening around the world and how amazing it is and just so much more. But I just also wanted to talk about CNN, ABC News, a bunch of Washington Post, New York Times. The worst one was Rolling Stone. Rolling Stone came out and said let me read you the headline. Sound of Freedom is QAnon conspiracy theory for fathers with brainworms. Dads with brainworms. Here it is. The Sound of Freedom is a superhero movie for dads with brainworms. And it's a true story of saving kidnapped kids. Does that tell you who these folks are batting for? My uncle was in secret operations with the government in Latin America, and he resigned out of his secret army commission, the CIA commission, because of human trafficking of orphans in the mid-1980s. So I've known about this forever. It's very real. And to have these sickos sit there and make jokes about it is beyond evil. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want to stop tyranny? Well, so does he. Live from the Infowars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
For joining us on this Sunday, July 9th, 2023 broadcast. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Okay, first off, what's left of the dinosaur corporate kleptocrat pedophile worshiping media has further dug itself into hell. And I would say, they've been a zombie organization, a zombie constellation of corporate fraudsters that have been propped up for a long time, but the facade is completely blown over and fallen on the side of the highway now. Whether it's the Washington Post or the New York Times or CNN, nauseating coverage defending pedophilia and saying that there is no child kidnapping, there is no child trafficking, it does not exist, and that Sound of Freedom being the number one movie at the box office, backed by Mel Gibson and others, is the most horrible thing on earth that the world's ever seen. And of course, it's a true story. And of course, anybody can research the UN and giant child kidnapping rings and snuff films. And back before there was total corporate control 10 years ago and back to a bunch of my films, it was mainstream news that the UN ran giant kidnapping operations all over the world. So the UN runs this. I mean, these people run this. And their apologist is the corporate media, and they've got such big wavos that they come out against a movie that's defeated everything at the box office, including Indiana Jones and the Temple of Feminism, or the latest movie they just came out with. So that's a big deal. We got the director and the star of the movie and all those other great people who I know are really awake on the show this week. Congratulations to them on that. But we've got to look, I don't want to pollute the show with this. Nobody wants to watch CNN clips. Nobody wants to see ABC News clips, but they literally attack the movie and say, don't go see it. It's terrible. There's no child trafficking. I mean, they go, well, there's a little bit, but it's not a big problem. Folks, it's the biggest crime going on Earth right now is the exploitation of children, whether it's in cobalt mines or germanium mines, or whether it is sex slavery or whether it's sweatshops. I mean, even the New York Times admits there's hundreds of thousands of children younger than 15 working in dangerous factories overnight and not even going to school in places like Michigan and Texas. And that's a federal crime they're supposed to enforce, and it's not being stopped. So, I mean, you go to the border right now and see people handing over newborn babies with no IDs, no DNA tests to just random strangers. We have shot the video over and over again. It's like shooting fish in a barrel. You've all seen the footage. It's on Band.video. We should repackage something of all those tapes this week and call it Beyond the Sound of Freedom and just say, here's just our footage in Texas. Every time we go, it's like, just drive down the street. Oh, there's people handing over kids to random people. Oh, here, let's go to the airport. It's the same Catholic Charities woman just handing newborn babies over here. There's no ID, but I'm her mother. And she goes back outside, gets another one. I'm the mother. You're allowed to take her. I give her up. It's just total criminal act. And then meanwhile, if I want to fly to that same airport in Brownsville or McAllen, they literally want to grab my wiener. They want to pat me down when I fly. Oh, let's pat you down, oh, terrorist. But the borders, they're just handing kids over. And they're running these headlines like, it's the same. There's no child trafficking. I mean, there's nothing going on. Just shut up. So I'm going to hit that. But let me tell you what else is coming up. I am proud of a lot of things. And the thing that I don't want to say proud, most satisfied about, is that when I go back and talk to these key people and track back what woke them up, the genesis of them waking up, it was this show and our guests, the things we've done, has been, in the main, the most prominent, successful organization at getting people to wake up to the New World Order. And so to all the listeners and backers and supporters, you really bet on the right horse. You bet on your own future. You bet on a winner. I mean, we're talking triple crown winner. Not me, this whole organization, the audience, the listeners, the supporters. Baby, you are absolutely nailing it, okay? But man, I gotta tell you, I can't keep track of it anymore. It's not just RFK Jr., it's not just Tucker Carlson, it's not just Russell Brand, it's not just Joe Rogan, it's not just all these Congress people and all these big Hollywood people, and the number one movies over and over again, everything is anti-New World Order truth. Joe Rogan completely comes out in the Ice Cube interview that I finally watched last week. And I mean, I've got all these clips like the world government's gonna enslave us and they're gonna control everything we do. We gotta stop the central bank digital currencies and it's absolute total crap for hour after hour. And Ice Cube, yeah, we gotta stop this world government. They wanna control our bodies, they're the enemy. And folks, people say, well, are they controlled opposition? No, Joe Rogan's not controlled opposition. No, Ice Cube's not controlled opposition. No, Mel Gibson, skip this break. No, Mel Gibson is not controlled opposition. It's just now it's safe for them to tell you what they already knew. Because they saw people like me coming out talking about it 25 years ago. And David Icke and others like, well, you get attacked when you do that. It's kooky. And then over time, they woke up. I mean, you know, Joe Rogan calling into my show on 9/11. That's a famous clip. He listened all the time. Me and Joe have been friends 25 years. And Joe knew I was right over the years because he would just be like, is it really that bad? Really, Alex? And finally, about 5 years ago, I got mad at him and confronted him about it. And I said, you need to choose a side. You either need to be against the New World Order or for it. And he said, you're right. It's real. I'm gonna be against it. And he's done it in his own way, fighting him. And I'm not like the traffic cop or the policeman here that, you know, tells people what they better do and what they, you know, it's not that. I want to beat the globalist. So if somebody's my friend, and I know they're smart, and they're denying this is going on, and they're not fighting it, and Joe gave me credit. It's not about credit. It's about this broadcast, its effectiveness on record, and then why you've supported it and why you should continue to. Because we're in battle, folks. You'd think the lead ship and the attack against the enemy would be the most backed out there. You know, it's kind of like, oh, that guy's right now. Now we're all going to move forward. Meanwhile, the enemy is encircling me because they don't want me to put out the next information that's going to stop them. So I got them stabbing me, literally, metaphysically, culturally, financially. And so I'm just saying, hey, here's our report back to you. We really did good on the battlefield. Can we please, as an old horse, be fed and basically patted down and not put away wet? And I'm not complaining. I am so excited about our success. But there is this moment of this all going mainline and people totally getting what's going on, this explosion out there, whereas you have to understand that some of these people, well, not the ones I listed, but some of them, could be getting involved in the movement, not just as a bandwagon, but because they want to lead the wagon later. And that's not the people I listed, not Tucker, not Joe. I know them really well, know Joe really well. That's not happening. It was just hard for them to admit this to themselves. But there are a lot of other people that are being basically establishment-backed that I don't trust. And look, I'm going to leave it to you to figure all this out. But, I mean, Trump standing ovation, Mel Gibson with Roger Stone and Trump and Joe Rogan standing ovations. I mean, we're the culture. We're winning. The coup d'etat of the Justice Department and the coup of the New World Order has failed. No one's buying it. Everyone sees through it. Trump in major polls was 67% of the field of Republicans. Out of all the Republicans, he had 67%. Now it's over 75. No one. He's 30 points ahead of Biden now in scientific polls. He was only 5 points in the election. They could steal that. You can't steal a margin of 10, 20, 30%. I mean, nobody since Franklin D. Roosevelt in World War II has been this popular. And he was in control. He was basically a dictator by that point in the war. And he did have 70% approval. Okay. Trump is as popular as he was right now in the real world. Not little leftist bubble pedo lands, but in the real country, in the real world, people know Trump's a maverick. They know the system's after him, and they want him. And so this is really a magic moment, ladies and gentlemen, that's happening. But the reason I was getting back into Rogan is this, that he's hitting on all cylinders. He said a few months ago, because I don't have time to, he does prolific stuff, so I watch probably 2 hours a week. I'd love to be able to watch more, but I'm doing my own show. And people sent me a clip where Rogan's like, yeah, it was Alex Jones telling me about central bank digital currencies and ESGs about 3-4 years ago, and it's all true, and it's super dangerous, and we got to really be worried about it. That was a couple months ago. Now he goes on 30-minute breakdowns on it. And once Joe Rogan starts looking at something, he's really good at covering it. So I got to say, there's a real satisfaction. Come on, I've been a long-distance swimmer. And or my ship sunk, and I had to swim 5 miles. And I'm not in good shape, but I can still swim 5 miles. I used to be a really good swimmer. I swam 2 miles just a few months ago easily in the Caribbean. But the point is, it's like swimming 5 miles in a heavy current. You're almost dead, and you get to the beach, and you're just exhausted and throw yourself on it. And so InfoWars is kind of like that. I've been on this long marathon swim, against the current, and I've hit the beach, and I'm just kind of collapsed here. But as I look up, I see all these other prominent people that really get it. And once you get the globalists are coming to destroy you, and once you get they're going to build a dystopia, and once you get they're not going to let you sell out to them, they want to be transhumanists, they're going to be God, they want to, smart people go, this is not going to work, this is going to blow the earth up. People are going to fight back, there's going to be a giant war. You're going to release new bioweapons and lock us down? You're going to engage in all of this? It's not going to fly once people know the globalists are predators and transhumanist psycho depopulationist. So once you get to that breaking point, which we've gone over, there's no way the New World Order wins, except they may be able to destroy the planet and take us with them. So now our job is to accelerate the awakening of the public and their full education. Not just they're somewhat awakened, one of the trip. We got to get them really red-pilled quickly before things go black pill. And we also have to talk to the establishment and just say, listen, you know you've lost, and we'll give you abstentia. You can go and take some of your stolen money. People say, oh, don't be a wimp. We want vengeance. No, you look at how wars get ended properly, and because you mark them, you expose them, by mark them in the media that they're bad. And then you destroy their name politically and culturally, and then you let them go, because they will blow stuff. They will blow the planet up if they're cornered. Now I'm trying to give the globalists a way out. I'm being completely straight with them. There's no way you make it out of this. If you want to try to run off and regroup for 50, 100 years and come back, we'll give you another shot at it, okay? The point is that God gives you another shot at. We know that in Revelation. The point is that you're not going to win this round, okay? And I'm not the type of guy that just says, let's play dice with this. Because there's a 60% chance if either side doesn't give up, they're going to blow the planet up. But we might as well just blow up the planet then, because if they're in control, it's pure Satanism, pure pedophilia, pure animal-human clones, them playing God, a psychotic mad scientist situation. So let's just cauterize it, vaporize it. Look, I'm in the same boat as they are. They're ready to blow it up if they're going to lose. I'm ready to blow it up if we lose too. In fact, I just want to be completely honest. People want to know what I really think. This is Next Level Alex Jones. I think instead of them getting full satanic control of the planet and doing this and turning us into lab rats, I think it's just best, God, I'm on that. God, go ahead and vaporize it if that's the right thing to do. Seriously. In fact, I'm asking, and I'm not praying to God to vaporize the earth. I want to fix things. I want to turn it around. I'm saying, if it gets to the point where we're not going to turn it around, and God knows that, and we've chosen wrong, I ask for the children's sake that God not allow the earth to continue on to produce children for this thing to feed on. I ask God respectively to blow the planet up immediately. Seriously. I mean, I want God to blow it up now instead of doing this, okay? And God says, you got to fix it. I'm on your side. I'll give you discernment. I'll give you backing. It's not over yet, Jones. And I know that. But for a real debate with the globalists and have a real discussion with them, they need to know. We're not backing off. We're not giving in. We're not going away. It's a game of chicken. In fact, we're talking about Mel Gibson. Pull up that classic Mad Max. Mad Max toe cutter scene. What a B movie, man. Wow. They can't make movies like this good with $500 million today because they have no soul. Pull up Mad Max toe cutter chicken scene And so I just want them to know we are Mad Max. In fact, we have the real, we have Mad Max on our team. Okay, we have Mel Gibson on our team. We have all the good guys. Okay, we're not perfect, we're maniacs, but you do understand we're not going to turn the car off in this chicken. We're going to jam the accelerator down and aim it straight at your ass. That's what we're telling you. You need to just turn off now. You need to turn off now. But hey, it's okay. If Tim Cook runs death camps, we know he's gay, right? Long as you're liberal, as long as it's fun, as long as it's trendy. So, the big news, enough about all that. But you have to understand, more than just news stories or news items, all this, freedom's popular, exposing the globalists is popular, standing against them is popular. The New World Order does not know what to do. They're in total and complete absolute panic mode right now. And that's just where we are. But let's not sit there and count our chickens before they're hatched. They're going to pull some major crap. I mean, they already said the Russians tomorrow are going to blow up the nuclear power plant with no evidence.
Metal damage.
Brain damage, huh?
Are you listening, Bronze?
I am the Knight Rider. I'm a fuel-injected suicide machine.
Classic.
Yeah. The toe cutter. He knows who I am. I am the Knight Rider.
Imagine CNN, Washington Post. We are another disgraceful.
I'm the chosen one. The minor hand.
Coming out and saying that there's no child kidnapping going on and that Sound of Freedom is bad when it's on the record, true story, and quite frankly, nothing compared to what goes on. I mean, they picked a completely confirmed one of these stories. I mean, the UN again has been caught literally kidnapping 10,000 children in Haiti alone. Guys, type into the search engine just the other day. Children kidnapped in Africa for satanic ritual sacrifice. That was like mainstream news 5 days ago. And there goes Klaus Schwab. They're a little intimidated now. They already know they're losing, but they don't quit. Because now we're on their tail. And now they're not as confident as they used to be. Because now we have the public awakening. And now Bill Gates and Fauci are starting to figure out what's going on. The world's awake to them now. And it's going to get worse from here on out. All we got to do is just keep pushing and pushing and pushing with the truth. They can try to censor. They can try to threaten. They can try to sue us. They can do whatever they want. But in the end, we know what happens. The bad guys. But of course, we know how evil works. They'll come back again and we'll beat them again. The question is, how many children are going to get chewed up and murdered and killed in the process before we stop these people? So there you go. I just had a hunger to suddenly see that, and we just played that, and there's my little allegory. I've got probably 200 articles here, and I've looked at them, and they're all incredible. Here's just one. Oh, yeah, show that AP. Somebody ought to call CNN up and say, you say there's no child trafficking going on. What's this? AP exclusive, UN child sex ring left victims but no arrests, including tens of thousands kidnapped, raped, and many murdered. And when AP published this, was this 5 years ago, 6 years ago? It got no coverage. It was like a 25-page report. We had reporters down there a year before this broke. Gary Haven and Joe Biggs. Oh, where's Joe Biggs? Joe Biggs was there documenting kidnapped children and getting authorities to save them with Gary Haven. Where's Joe Biggs right now? Oh, he's in a federal prison. He's a terrorist. I forgot. So look at this. In fact, guys, print me a bunch of articles about sex trafficking and UN sex trafficking and UN kidnapped kids and just... You'll have to go to Google Web, though, because none of it's in the news now. They hide it. But we've got all the thousands of articles, congressional hearings, all of it. But remember, the sound of freedom's not real. None of it's happening. None of it's going on. Yeah, well, my uncle, my mom's brother, who was probably the coolest guy I ever knew, so sad he died of flash pneumonia 9 years ago in 2014. He told me before he died, the government was smuggling children out of Central America out of orphanages. Now, when he told me that before he died, I knew he was a very good guy and an amazing person and the top of his class and basically everything. The youngest person to ever have a ham radio operation license when he was like 10 years old. He had world records at different points in his life for Morse code. Super decorated Vietnam helicopter pilot, and then went into secret operations. And he said, our government kidnaps and smuggles children and kills them. That was William Forrest Hammond told me that. Oh, but I can read CNN, and they tell me none of that's going on. The criminals that have hijacked our government use this to compromise people, and you don't get in their club unless you're part of that. And that's who's hijacked the U.S. government. So remember when you see CNN or the Washington Post or the New York Times, they don't just lie to you. I've got all the articles, the videos. You want me to play them for you? You see it everywhere. They're literally saying people that believe this movie have maggots in their brains. You can read the disdain in the headlines. I mean, I've got a whole bunch of them here. They're just sick. They'll take a true story on record with arrest and convictions and say it in real to you because they love it, because they support it. It was Operation Underground Railroad, 6,000 trafficking victims rescued on record. And what is their response? No, don't go see Sound of Freedom. It's a QAnon conspiracy. It's literally based on a true story, ladies and gentlemen. Report, Rolling Stone writer who mocks Sound of Freedom movie locks down his Twitter profile. Look at this guy. I mean, I'm just saying, somebody ought to like, I mean, he looks like Brian. He's kind of got a little Brian Stelter flavor to him. Not going to let this guy babysit my kids. I'll put it to you that way. Yeah, here's what he wrote. Sound of Freedom is a superhero movie for dads with brain worms. You know, those dirty dads. And what did Biden start doing, Obama, a month ago? No longer does ICE, when there's an unaccompanied child from the age 18 down to 3 months, or newborn, do a DNA test when they're released to the charities. They have no ID, have no idea who the kid is. They don't take their DNA, so they find them dead a year later or 6 months later or 5 years later. There's no ID, no ID, no DNA. So when they go right into those Satanist hands, and I've been there when they're handing over babies with no paperwork at the airport. Got it on video. You've seen it. There's no record. But when we fly to the border and we try to fly out, my crew's been standing there. We usually drive. We've flown some. My crew's been standing there before because we have equipment. We're pulled aside. We're doing, sir, we're doing a check. Hands under here. Guys grab my balls, grab the crew's balls. And I'm sitting there watching illegal aliens just led through and little kids just led through with no nothing. They just have envelopes going God knows where while some TSA person tugs at my wiener. That's how crazy this country is and what a joke it's become. But we have to admit this to ourselves and understand it. So the good news is their house of cards is coming down. Now, I'm going to get into a bunch of other news when we come back. I'm going to get into the central bank digital currency, Joe Rogan coming out and issuing this emergency warning that's excellent. And then I'm going to get into China cutting off rare earth minerals in the United States, a gigantic deal I've warned of for more than 15 years, and it's now happened. I mean, this is next level. For those that don't know, you can't build jack squat without these two elements they just banned. You can't build a toaster. We'll be right back. One of the biggest reasons all over the world George Soros and the criminals that have hijacked our government are trying to defund the police is to get their people in once they brought the police into submission. They fire half the cops, things burn down, then they put their new police in, and then nobody investigates the sex trafficking. And when my uncle was dying, about a year before he died, he told me some of this when he was dying, before he lungs filled up, and they put him on a respirator and he died. He lived about a week on it. He said, listen, this is really dangerous. He said, I don't want to tell you this. You're already on it. You already know what's going on, but it's real. And that's what we saw in Central America. We were down there in Iran-Contra. That's why me and some of the other men got out of it. They killed some of the people. And he goes, they killed some of the guys that got out of it with him. And they killed them. I mean, you understand? I got my uncle off a C-130 in Dallas when I was like 8 years old and had no idea. My dad was working. We went to the Air Force base and C-130 lands, and he comes off on crutches. And it's just the full story. Even my family doesn't know, but I mean, it's just insane, folks. And then I see CNN saying it doesn't exist. I have a stack of AP Reuters articles that never got any traction about the UN running giant child kidnapping rings. I'll cover next hour. I mean, this is just what you can find in 10 seconds. There's thousands of these things. I mean, you read about the industrial level. Like you see those cobalt mines in Congo and Africa where they're like 3 miles wide. You see like eight-year-old kids in there working 14 hours a day, and they just die. They throw them in mass graves. If they'll put kids in a cobalt mine, you know how toxic that stuff is? With no gloves, no nothing, no shoes in many cases. Literally what we envision as Israelite slaves building Pharaoh's pyramids. We see that in movies and say, oh, that really happened. Well, pull up a lithium mine, a cobalt mine, a geranium mine in Africa. Yeah, look at this. This is real. This is real. Now, if they'll do that to little kids, of course they're raping this living snot out of them. And they do it. And then I have clip after clip of CNN laughing and saying it's not happening. How did we produce scum of this level? But guys, show them a photo of a lithium or cobalt mine or a geranium mine. I mean, they're like 3, 4, 5 miles wide, and there's no machines. It's people. And it caves in, and people die every hour. And then again, this is electric cars. Have nothing to do with the environment. It's all a giant scam. Oh, God help us. And then it gives China full control. So I'm gonna hit more of this coming up next hour. I'm gonna show you the headlines, all of it. I mean, here's one: more than 100 UN peacekeepers ran a child sex ring. AP report documents child sexual abuse by UN peacekeepers in Haiti. NPR, AP investigation: UN troops lured kids into Haiti sex ring. Oxfam criticized over Haiti's sex claims. Yeah, the so-called liberal aid groups. Sex charges haunt UN forces. That's just in Haiti. It's all over the world, folks. This is just the latest scandal. And then go to Infowars.com to the articles we have, and they're full of dozens of clips. This one right here. Washington Post, London Guardian, all of them. Making jokes about it. It's funny. You go on Twitter, the left's making all these jokes about, it's so funny little kids kidnapped. It's so funny 5-10 men raping them a day. It's real. And then I look at, I'm a news junkie, so I see the news that becoming a national story. If some black drug addict gets killed by a cop accidentally, and I don't care if it's a white drug addict, black drug addict, whatever, the point is I'm sad they're dead. It's not on purpose. And it's number one story. Half the country burns. It's the end of the world. And then I'll see some story out of Dallas or Austin, or because it's on the local news. It's like, little girl was at Spurs games with dad. Dad went in bathroom, told her to stand there. Eight-year-old grabbed, found 2 weeks later in Oklahoma City in a room raped by 400 men. It's like, when the police got there, there were 17 men lined up to rape her, and they believe over 400 men raped her. I mean, you're like reading local news, 400 men raped a little girl. I mean, and then you turn on CNN, and they're like, there's nothing going on. I got a six-year-old daughter. I got two other daughters. And I'm telling you, man, you're crossing the line, CNN. and you're crossing the line, New York Times and Washington Post and all the rest of you damn people. You think it's funny what you do to us. You see us as food that you eat. You see our kids as, look at the schools. Look at the drag queen pedophile time. Look at all of it. It's who they are. They're soulless scum who have nothing. So they want our innocence. They want our children. They want our future. I have a stack of articles of mainstream media, CNN and others, bitching that, oh my God, since abortion got restricted in Texas, there were 10,000 more births. Oh, but all the illegals you bring in are the most precious people on earth because you're exploiting them. They're already born. But if, oh no, Texas, we didn't kill them. They're literally bemoaning. There were 10,000 births in Texas. The majority of them Hispanic babies that they can't kill. And this is good, the crew found, but guys, type in rare earth mineral mine from space. I want people to see Central Africa, it's all over Africa. I want you to see the 5 mile, 6 mile, 3 mile wide craters they're in, where they march down into it. Can we show a rare earth mineral mine from the air? Can we, you showed it the other day on the show on Friday. Yeah, that, look at that. That's a small one. That's about a mile wide. Type in biggest rare earth mineral, biggest rare earth mineral mine on earth. I think one of them is 7 miles wide. They estimate about 300 people die a day in it. That's what I read a few months ago. But again, it's all liberals. Like, well, if the owners of the companies are like Tim Cook and a little black turtleneck, it's like, well, he's gay running death camps with 3 million Uyghurs. Like, well, I mean, he runs death camps, but he's gay. It's like, well, okay, we get it. He's gay. It's fine. It's loving. I haven't put the Joe Rogan clip yet. I haven't gotten to any of it yet because I'm just so wound up here. But you want to know how they're going to get you. It's going to be the central bank digital currency. It's going to be, this is their mark of the beast. This is it. And the good, and people are like, oh, Joe Rogan. Yeah. He's got the biggest show. And once he goes against the system, it's just a bellwether. Everybody else is going against it. It shows we're waking up. It shows positive things are happening. Yeah, there's one of the bigger ones. Look at that gigantic monster. And do you know what all that green sludge is down in there? Just to mine gold, it creates a ton of cyanide. And humans aren't supposed to be involved in it. You have any idea in a lithium or cobalt or any of these other mines what leaches out of that stuff? You're going to be dead real quick because it goes right in your skin. And then, oh, look at this little story. Wall Street Journal. China controls minerals that run the world, and they just fired a warning shot at the U.S. Well, I love the Chi-Com worshiping media. It's right here. I love the Chi-Com worshiping media. They didn't fire a warning shot. If I walk up to you and shoot you in the knee with a 12-gauge shotgun and blow your leg off at the knee, I didn't fire a warning shot. If I walk up to you with a meat cleaver and hack your carotid artery open, I didn't fire a warning shot. I love how they spin their stuff, baby. They just cut off the key to rare earth minerals 100%. You're like, well, we'll just have our own mine. We don't have any mines. We're not allowed to have mines here. Not diamond mines, not gold mines. There's not one lead smelting facility in the United States. We're not allowed to. Environmentalists. It has nothing to do with the environment. It's about strategic control. China has 98% control of rare earth minerals. 98%. They didn't get it by accident. Like Joe Biden does. They were given control by the criminals that run our government. That set everything up over there. But I'll just be like CNN. They say pedophilia doesn't exist. Child trafficking doesn't exist. Well, rare earth minerals don't exist. They could probably get Joe Biden. Rare earth minerals don't exist. China didn't cut them off. It's in all the electronics, and they just cut them off completely. The two, you're like, well, they didn't cut off the other 10. They cut off the two you got to have to complete it to make any microchip. Total cutoff. You're like, well, I've got oil for my engine. You don't have gasoline. Well, no, I don't. Comprende? Comprehend what I'm saying. We're going to go to break. Hey, I'm not funded by George Soros, the New World Order. I'm funded by you. If you like somebody fighting back and not rolling over, go to InfoWarsStore.com. Our July 4th mega sales going on right now, up to 60% off incredible products that enrich your life, 10% off of storable food and water filtration, which is their highest quality, which you need. We got stuff you need. We need funds. It's a war. You want to fight the pedos? Then back this maniac that doesn't back down. I don't back down, but I could give out. I need your support. Take action now. InfoWarsStore.com. Nitric Boost, Ultimate Bone Broth, Incredible CBD Oil. It's all there. InfoWarsStore.com. Take action now. InfoWarsStore.com or roll over to pedos.